students, welcome to our science classes. And let us continue our lesson, chemical effects of electric current. In chemical effects of electric current, in the previous classes, we have studied about the electrolysis. Now, let's study about electroplating. To understand this electroplating thoroughly, let's perform an activity. To perform this activity, we need 4 dry cells, a thick copper wire, connecting wires, beaker, iron nail, vinegar and a piece of sandpaper. I will say the required things once again. 4 dry cells, a thick copper wire, connecting wires, a beaker, iron nails, vinegar and a piece of sandpaper. So let us start our activity. For starting this activity, to take copper wires or connecting wires and sandpaper. You know what we have to do with sandpaper and connecting wires. The ends of the connecting wire has to be cleaned with the help of sandpaper. Okay, after that, what we have to do symbolically, I have represented here. We have to take the beaker. You can take vinegar into this beaker. That means more than half of the beaker should be filled with vinegar. Okay, through this vinegar, we have to add copper coil. We are asked to take a thick copper wire. That thick copper wire, we have to make it in the shape of a wound. We have to take in the shape of a coil. Copper wire, thick copper wire we have taken, that make it in the shape of a coil. Okay, this coil we have to insert it into the beaker. What is contained in the beaker? Our beaker contains vinegar. To this beaker we have to add coil, copper coil. So what is vinegar? Chemical name of vinegar is ethanoic acid, or really it is acetic acid. Acetic acid. So we have added copper to acetic acid, and we have to leave it undisturbed for nearly 8 to 10 hours. We have to keep it without disturbing for 8 to 10 hours. So after that, so if we kept for 8 to 10 hours, we can see that some of the copper, why we have dipped this copper wire in vinegar? Because vinegar, yes, part of this copper will be dissolved in vinegar. Little copper, it will be get dissolved in vinegar. So after 10 to 12 hours, we have to remove that, the copper coil. Okay. Now, after that, we can make the arrangement like this. We have taken the beaker. That beaker contains copper dissolved vinegar. So this copper dissolved vinegar, and after that we have to make it to electrodes. Do you remember electrodes? So electrodes are the wires or rods that connects electricity to the electrolyte. Actually here acetic acid is the electrolyte. So we have to make it to electrodes. And first electrode, what is that? Positively charged electrode, that is known as anode. Positively charged electrode is known as anode. To the anode we have to connect this copper coil. Already we have made the copper coil. That copper coil we have to connect it to this wire. That wire has to connect to positive terminal. So this is what is called anode. And next one, we have to take another one copper wire. So that extend the copper wire itself, no problem. That copper wire, we have to, one side of the copper wire we have to dip it in a copper containing acetic acid or copper dissolved acetic acid, and other end we have to connect it to the negative terminal of the battery. Okay, our circuit is ready. And now what we have to do? Now we have to leave it undisturbed for 30 seconds. So here we have taken copper. We have taken the copper wire. One end of the copper wire we have to connect it to positive terminal. So other end we have to connect the copper coil. We have connected the copper coil. So this copper coil is the anode here, because copper coil, it is connected to positive terminal. Okay, now here what we have to see, here we have to take the iron nail. What we said, we are asked to take one iron nail. That iron nail we have to connect it to the copper wire or connecting wire. So iron nail, here it is cathode. Iron nail is cathode. So anode is ready, cathode is ready. Anode is copper coil and cathode is iron nail. Yes, leave it undisturbed for 30 minutes. After 30 minutes, we can see that there will be a coating. There will be a copper coating on the iron nail. So iron nail will be covered with copper. So how does it happen, or what is the scientific side behind this? Let us see. Here we have taken anode. Here it is cathode.
Already we said that in acetic acid copper has been dissolved. Copper that contained in the acetic acid that goes to, when the electricity is passed, copper, it is positively charged. Copper is positively charged ion. Copper is positive charge. So this copper moves to cathode. What is there in the cathode? There will be iron nail. So this iron nail will be covered with copper. Okay. At the same time, in the anode, what happens? This copper, the copper which is deposited on the iron nail, it has come from this vinegar. So as it goes from the vinegar, some copper from this copper coil, it gets dissolved in acetic acid, or it gets dissolved in vinegar. So this process continues. So if we leave it for more time, what happens? We will get a thick coating of copper on the iron nail. We get a thick coating of copper on the iron nail. So if we want to increase its thickness, two things we have to do. What is that? We have to continue this electroplating for more time. So we have to increase the time. As the time increases, thickness of the copper coating on iron nail increases. Another one, we have taken here four cells. Instead of four, if we are increasing the number of cells, then also amount of substance deposited on the cathode, it will be more. Okay, so this experiment, it says that the amount of substances liberated or amount of metal deposited on the cathode during electrolysis depends on two things. What are they? First, the time for which the electrolysis has been taken place. Second one, the amount of current passes through the electrolyte. So these are the two factors. What are they? First one, the time for which the electrolysis has been conducted, and the second one, the strength of the electric current.